Gates of the World, episode 3. And this will be an adventurous cooking episode. So keep watching to find out what we will be cooking. So the first thing I'm going to make, I would like to have a drink while I'm cooking, is boba tea. So boba is these right here, tapioca's pearls. So I bought a big package. They look like this. Tapioca pearls. I'm using rainbow ones and bobas. They're boba. So you can buy premium ones that cook like an hour and stuff, but I have a lot to do, so these luckily are ready in 5 minutes. So boil water. I use half a cup of bobas, and after that we are just going to take them and strain them really quickly. After you strain them, you're going to want to shock them in ice water. So I just have some ice water, and we are going to mix these with the ice water. Until they have cooled down a fair amount. So you just want these to be cool, and then take them out of the ice water, like that. And so next we are going to add flavor to these. These are flavorless bobas. For my flavoring, I'm adding simple syrup. You can add agave nectar, honey, or sugar, or any other sweetening agents you want. So I'm just going to mix these a little bit. And if they aren't as sweet as I would like, I'll probably add just a little sugar. And just mix those well. So to the side here, take a mason jar and sweetened condensed milk. Add about a tablespoon of sweetened condensed milk. I might add a little bit more because I prefer my tea sweet when I drink tea. And because it's not coming off the spoon 100% correctly. So I'd say this is like a tablespoon and a half to two tablespoons and a half now. Doesn't have to be perfect. I have boiled and steeped black tea. I did 2 cups, so we're just going to add our black tea here. I'm using Earl Grey black tea, decaf. But use the black tea that you would like, or for that matter, any sort of tea. Add some ice. And once you have added your ice, you're going to take this. You can mix it. I'm going to shake it really well. So once you have shaken it, take some boba, and your tea, gonna add some more boba. And your boba straw. And we're going to give it a taste. Really good. They're like chewy, how I wanted them. And it's sweet, the sweet texture I wanted. So keep watching for the rest of today's episode. So continuing on with this episode, today I ended up changing my menu back to what I originally had planned. So I'm going to be making bulgogi. I think that's how you pronounce it. This is not the exact authentic way. This is my style. So you're going to need your beef, stir fry style. I have two packages, Korean barbecue, Maggi seasoning, soy sauce, some salt, sesame oil. So, oh, and rice vinegar, just a little bit. So, your bowl and your spoon to mix. Probably end up using the metal one. So, start out shaking this. Smells so good. I'm going to add, I'd say, at least half a cup or a fourth, anywhere between a fourth and a half cup. Okay, Maggi, I love Maggi, so I'm going to add not a lot of Maggi, but I'd say at least two or three tablespoons for the amount of beef I have. Okay, that's about right. Soy sauce, I'm using naturally brewed soy sauce. And it's just plain. They have like different flavors at my local World Market. So I'm using like 4 or 5 tablespoons. Not too much, because soy sauce, it can be super salty, depending on how salty it is. About 1 tablespoon of rice vinegar. About 1/2 teaspoon of sesame oil. And about 1/8 teaspoon of salt. So mix that, and we are going to cut open our beef and start to mix the beef in with the marinade for our beef. Now, this beef is the beef you would use for stir fry, so I'm using 2 packages of this. And it's thinly sliced and it's in strips. So, and we're going to marinate this for about 30 minutes to an hour. You can marinate it overnight for the best results, but I would have had to do that last night. So this is over 1 pound. I'd say it's at least 2, if not 2.5. So typically you would buy bulgogi beef. It's a special kind, but I really like this beef to go with my bulgogi. I've always used this kind whenever I've made it. And I just kind of fry it for a couple minutes until it's nice and crispy. And might even end up mixing it with my hands. So mix this well and cover all the beef in this marinade. And I'm just going to kind of flatten it out like this, as you can see. Take my glove off. And there's the marinade for the bulgogi. So now we are going to work on the dumpling filling, and for this you will need ground pork or ground beef, which I'm using ground beef, green onion, and some sesame seeds and soy sauce. So you're also going to want to be heating up some oil. In this pot I have about tablespoon at least of some sesame oil heating up. So once you have heated it, you're going to want to add your green onion. Oh, you'll also need a little bit of salt of your choice, sea salt, kosher salt, any sort of salt that you would like. So I'm going to go ahead and cut open my meat. I prefer beef over pork, so that's why I'm using beef. And once they've been in there for a couple of seconds or minutes or so, go ahead and add your meat. We're going to turn the heat up to about a high heat. For me, the sesame seeds are optional. I add them for a little texture and flavor. I use one small packet of meat, package of meat, but you can do like a large package or whatever. Now I'm going to add salt to taste. I'm using Korean sea salt, and just add it to your taste. A And now we are just going to let the meat cook a little bit. Oh, I'm sorry about this, but we also need a little bit of gochujang or hot pepper powder. So just about a teaspoon, because this is a small pack of meat and I don't want it to be too flaky. Smells so good. Okay, now at this point I'm going to add about half a teaspoon to 1 teaspoon of soy sauce. And that's how you make the filling for the dumplings. So now we are going to wrap some dumplings with the filling that we made. So here's our filling. And I have this packet of dumpling wrappers that I bought today. You'll see that at the end of the cooking show. So this I actually thought was one of the ones that you peel open, but it's not. So I'm not a perfectionist at this. So you'll need some water for that. So here, we're going to take dumpling wrapper, fill it with some of the mixture. I think that's enough. Do half with water, like one half of it. Flip it over and do this. Like that. And then I'm just going to add this step. This part's optional. You can leave it halfway done. You can do this. But I think this gives it a nice touch. And make sure it's secure. And that's a dumpling. Another way you can do a dumpling is to, well, if I can get this, okay. Take some filling. You can really fold them any way you want, but bring up these two ends and then bring this one and this one. So like that. Those two. I recommend this one, but that is up to you. So we're just going to finish doing some dumplings. I'm not gonna use all the mixture because it is a lot and I don't want too many dumplings tonight. You can fill the dumplings with anything you want. You can do tofu, you can do pork, you can do beef, chicken, lamb, shrimp, anything. the first time I ever made dumplings, it was like the worst thing ever. Like, didn't know what I was doing. And when I went to check on them, I just opened the container and all the steam came up to my face. And I literally thought all my eyebrows had burned off. Like, or just poof. If you put too much mixture, it will fall out when you're trying to fold it. So that's why I'm doing like half a spoonful, or if it's a full spoon, then it's a small full spoon. I have made egg rolls. My grandma used to make homemade egg rolls. And then I've made egg rolls before. That wasn't a 100% very good experience either, because I had already wrapped like 5 or 6 and I hadn't even cooked the cabbage that I was putting into it, cabbage and carrots. So I didn't worry about those, and I cooked the cabbage and carrots, the rest of the mixture I had, and my aunt helped me roll them because I wasn't rolling them right. Some of these you might not need water, actually, because I noticed that when I put some beef on, for some reason they get a little bit wet. That was my race. Let me check on it. One second. Okay. So just continue to do these. And I'll be back when they're ready to be steamed. Hey guys, so I'm here with the dumplings. And I discovered this shape. I like this shape. I have 15 dumplings. And normally I like my bamboo steamer, but today we're using this one. So we're going to set the dumplings in there, lined. Well, actually, what you actually want to do is oil the pan a little bit. The thing, whatever it's called, the steamer. So that your dumplings won't stick. And so I'm just going to oil my steamer. To set the dumplings in here.
And you can, like, stack them in things, but I'm determined to fit them. There we go. Put your top on, and we're going to steam these for 20 to 25 minutes. Okay. Now that has gotten started. Okay. So we'll be back when those are done steaming. So we're starting with the vegetables now, and you're going to want to have a tablespoon of sesame oil and add your vegetables that you're using. I'm using green beans and broccoli, but use the vegetables of your preference. So we're just going to saute these for a couple seconds before we add our other ingredients to our noodles. Okay, so once you have it sauteed a little bit, just a little bit, you don't need to hear all the sizzle and stuff, you're going to add about half a teaspoon of onion powder and about a teaspoon of garlic powder, or you can use fresh garlic, but right now I'm sticking with garlic powder. And mix that thoroughly. And once you have that mixed, add 2 tablespoons of rice vinegar. 1 tablespoon of Maggi. And 1.5 tablespoons of soy sauce. And about a teaspoon of salt. And again, I'm using my Korean sea salt. And once you have all those added, go ahead and mix it some. I made hot chili oil. I'm just going to use about like a teaspoon or so. Not too much. So give it a small taste and see what you need to adjust. Okay, mine tastes fine. And 1 teaspoon or so of gochugaru. That's up to you how much you add. So now, you're just going to let these kind of cook in the broth we made. And once those are done, we will just set those aside. Hey guys, so we're back with the kimbap. For this, you will need rice, cucumber, carrots, and nori. and your mat. So take a sheet of nori and put it down, not shiny side up. Okay. And then rice. I mixed the rice with some sesame seeds and rice vinegar. It's optional, mix it with what you would like. And just spread it out. Leave about an inch space at the top or end, whichever you prefer. As you can see, I'm doing the end. Doesn't have to be perfect. Go ahead and take a few cucumbers and carrots. You can fill this with whatever you like. I don't like seafood and I did not want to add meat, so. Now, this is the part that I've always had trouble with, rolling. So, take it and go like this. And then another, I guess. And just.
Oh, maybe what you say is.
That turned out pretty good. So I'm gonna finish letting this rice cool. I wanted to show you all how to do that. And. Graham. So just go ahead and finish cutting it. And once you have cut it, place it on the plate you're going to have it on. I'm going to work on like this little side in it sauce. You will need bell peppers, colors of your choice. Just take some of them, then take a green onion that you have boiled, wrap it around, and tuck it under. Okay. And once you have that done, just set it there. So for the sauce, I have these little cups, but they won't come apart, so. For the sauce, you're going to take soy, rice vinegar, and Maggi. Let me give it a taste. Really good. So
So just keep wrapping them like I showed you. Hey guys, so this is the final part and I will be tasting each and everything that we made today. So I guess I will start with some of the vegetables. This is a green bean, as you can see. Okay, I can't see me. There. They're really good. So the broccoli. That's good. Rice. Okay. Piece of beef. For the beef, I just fried it in a little sesame oil. And noodles. I did make noodles. I didn't show that on camera. They're good. And one of our little peppers with the sauce. That's well too. Hope you all enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe for more of Eats Around the World. I really hope you all enjoyed all of these recipes, and this was Eats of the World episode 3. And I'm going to go ahead and post a small clip and you will see what it is of with my voiceover. And this international food store has a whole bunch of noodles. So I was looking at the main noodles that there were. And I ended up getting corn noodles. And I really did not like them. They weren't. I'll probably try. So that's what is going on.
I read on the bottle, and I remember looking at the bottle specifically in that class and looking at the red top, the yellow label, and I did find the one I was looking for. So there, I'm just kind of explaining to my grandmother that I found the soy sauce. And last getting here in second, we're walking toward the refrigerated section. And I went ahead, and I was going to get rice cakes, but I didn't. And I got dumplings afterwards. So I hope you all enjoyed this video. And that was it for today's episode of Eat of the World, episode 3. I hope you all like this video.